Welcome to ColorAnt 11. For the custom chart, we've simplified and optimized the interface to improve both efficiency and usability. The new linearization mode is a combination of several previous linearization options. It combines these modes with two new checkboxes for linearization and ink splitting and add G7 patches, which adds the relevant patches when activated. The Spot Color Library option is now a combination of the previous Spot Color Library and CXF X4 Wedge. It contains all the functions of the former Spot Color Library dialog, but also the new Add Overprint on Black option. After activating this checkbox, the drop-down menu Number of Patches on Black becomes available, which allows the selection of the required number of overprint patches. We have also added a new option, Complementary Mini Charts. They are intended to complement profiling with spot colors via Edit Primaries. As there are more secondaries included in the chart, it generates very small charts with small gradients for the primaries and two color overprints for the 50% and the 100% combinations. Edit Primaries. Density changes can now be applied directly to the primary colors in the Edit Primaries tool. This allows density changes to be evaluated without having to print a new profiling chart. For example, in flexo printing, when a new analogs roll is used for a primary color, or in offset printing, if the density of an ink is increased or decreased. If the density of a primary color changes, corresponding lab values are calculated and applied by the Edit Primaries tool. This is based on the spectral information of the primaries. Hence, the density option is only available for a loaded test chart with spectral measurement data. To do so, click on the pencil icon to open the Edit Primaries dialog. The value under density indicates the current density taken from the measurement data. Enter the new density value and click on the triangle to apply the changes. The lab values are automatically calculated and displayed immediately. Clicking on OK accepts these values and closes the window. The calculation can be abandoned by clicking Cancel or reverted by clicking on the Undo arrow to restore the original values. The Adopt Secondaries function in the Edit Primaries tool has been revised and enhanced. As before, the checkbox is only available if the secondary colors are present for at least two of the selected colors of a measurement file. At least one 100-100 color patch for the selected colors must be present for the checkbox to be activated. In addition, other two color combinations are now considered as well. This can be any combination. The lab values, or spectral values, if available, are then retrieved from the measurement file and entered into the spectral model. By supporting any existing printed secondary combinations besides 100-100, the calculations are more precise. Compensation curves can now be saved in the CF curve format. This is a JSON format that is compatible with hybrid CloudFlow, allowing the compensation curves to be imported into these applications. The tone value curves can also be calculated to comply with the requirements of BVDM ISO 12647-2 offset printing standards. The new options have been added to the Correction According to TVI Targets drop-down menu of the Tone Value tool. We now provide easy import of data via an Excel spreadsheet provided on our website. The first page is an introduction to the sheet and instructions for use. And the other tabs allow for multiple data formatting and color spaces. You can then just export this page as a CSV and import or drag and drop into ColorAnt. This will carry over your data into a usable format, including tint values. The Barbieri Swing QB is now available in the list of supported devices in the Measure tool. The device can be connected via USB or Ethernet. Click on the network icon next to the Connect button to open the network setup. If the IP address and the port of the device are already known, you can enter them directly. However, it is possible to search for devices in the network and select one from the list. This option is also available for the Barbieri LFP. When measuring, make sure the markings are on the left and bottom of the sheet and follow the remaining instructions. There is now more flexibility when working with spot color libraries. Options can be found in the context menu, merging and conversions. One option is spot color library to DCS, which will convert the spot color library to a color space in line with the amount of colors available. You can also choose to create charts from spot colors, which will create individual charts from those spot colors. This can also be reversed by selecting Merge Charts to Spot Color in the context window. Some settings in the Preferences window have also been changed. The Delta E method is now a global setting that will be used in view and reporting. The Preferences window now offers the new option, Custom Directories, to select custom report, chart, and profile directories. The custom profile directory defined here is an additional directory alongside the system profile directory. These are just the highlights of what's new in ColorAnt 11, but we also have other quality of life features added, such as more comprehensive support for CIE files, improved exchange of spot color libraries between ColorAnt and ZePrA, and remembering positioning and sizing of windows. For comprehensive instructions on the capabilities and functions of ColorAnt and our other applications, Copra and ZePrA, please visit our online help. Thanks for watching.